Hello guys, today I'm going to talk about parent-child communication in Vue framework. So in general, I mean, modern day web apps we see are all mainly component based. So it is actually the whole interface is constructed of hierarchy of components here. So each component has specific responsibility, simple behavior, and all of them make up to the beautiful UI which we generally see. For example, if I consider the example here, so this is a snippet from Amazon. So the price component we see here is dependent on the variant we have. So there are two variants here. One is 32 GB and 64 GB. The price is dependent on the variant selection here. So if you select 32 GB, the price changes. That means some sort of communication should happen between the two components. So imagine at a scale. Imagine an interface, a big interface with a lot of components inside, and I mean the sort of communication should happen for all of them to work together. So that means communication is very important between all of the components here. So what are the various ways of communication for each component to talk to another one? So yeah, in general web frameworks use these kind of strategies or patterns to establish the communication between components here. First one is props, refs, global event bus, custom events, and we can even use Vuex store to manage the data between two components, and we have something like dependency injection. These are Vue specific, and these are very similar to what we have in React as well. So for example, dependency injection is similar to that of context API in React, and props or refs are very similar to that of React. And this today's talk is, I'm just going to talk about only parent-child communication. I'm just going to talk about few of the patterns here. Yeah. So, we have seen an example there. So many web apps we need to have the communication between parent and child. So how a parent can communicate to a child, and how can a parent pass the data to a child, and how can a parent call methods in the child, and vice versa, how can child inform parent about certain messages to be passed. So these are done using props, refs, and custom events. So I'm taking a simple case here to explain the three cases. So this is a simple use case. This one is a snippet from Medium. So this one is constructed of two components. First one is the index page, and the next one is the blog post title, let's say. So the parent component index page has all the data to be rendered in terms of blog posts here. So it has, for example, here it has three objects about three blog posts, and parent component passes down it initiates three child components and passes down each object to its child component here. So how do we do this? It uses a simple concept called props. Props are custom attributes given by JS, Vue JS, and registered on the component actually. And when a value needs to be passed as a prop, it becomes a property on the child component itself. And if you see, a title is passed, a prop title is expected in the child component. A prop title is expected in the child component here, and blog post component is instantiated here with the title blog post. So that means, so we just pass the string here and it gets rendered in the child component. And let's look at a little more complex example here. Here, post is being passed as a prop, which is an object. So in general, the rule of thumb is, we do not try to modify the data in a child. That means, actually the post belongs to the parent component, which we do not try to change it in the child component. We just ask parent to modify the data whenever it is required. So, and we have vbind here, which means it binds the data between parent and child. whenever there's a change in the parent's data, the same gets reflected in the child as well. And if you see 20 likes, so I'm adding one functionality to explain custom events here. That means how the messages are passed back to the parent. So for example, we have 20 likes here, a post has this attribute called number of likes. So when user likes it, we need to display that likes there at the you know, in the blog post component here. So whenever you do a like, the number needs to be reflected. As I said, we will not try to modify the component, data in the child component. We pass it to the parent and try to modify it. So that is where we use custom events. Whenever the like button is clicked, so it emits an event called it calls a function called emit with the event name and with the post ID here. The post ID is the data that we pass back to the parent, and in the parent we register this event. This created hook, this is a lifecycle function in Vue. So as soon as the component is created, we just try to bind a custom event with the name onLike, and as soon as this is fired, we call this function onLike. And when user tries to click the onLike button here, this will be fired, onLike function will be fired and increases the likes here. And as we have written vbind here, the same will get reflected in the child component as well. That increases the count to 21. For example, if the count is 20 here. Now, there's another way to communicate. There's another way for a parent to communicate with the child, that is with refs. Refs are nothing but references to the components inside. So when the view is being rendered, the component prepares, the refs are prepared and attached to the component. So we can actually reference to any child component from the parent using the refs. There will be a refs array with the parent component here. So for example, I'm taking a use case here. I'm just trying to make the blog post popular, auto popular, if the number of counts, if the number of likes count reaches to 50, let's say. So as soon as one user clicked like there, that reaches the parent component, that reaches 50, and then we communicate with this back to child. So for example, here this dot refs of blog post ref ID will refer to the first child component here, and mark as favorite actually makes the that blog post particular blog post popular. So these are basic communication strategies which are used between parent and child. That's all from me today. Any questions?
So refs is like pointers.
Yes. Refs is like pointers. Ref part. Okay. So when the component is being rendered for the first time, so each in the div part, if you have references mentioned, so it creates references for each of the child component rendered and keeps that references at the parent in an array. Yes, ref attribute, vref attribute at the HTML. Yes, we can reference the immediate child. From that, we can take the reference of any child. So
even if you use reference, you have to call the parent if you want to make any changes. The child can't make changes.
So the child do not make changes because in general, if the data is owned by a component, we let only that component modify the data, because if it will be ambiguous. So many other components try to modify the same data. If I rephrase that question, it's about what can we modify the data in the child component, right? Yeah.
When we should use refs and when we should be using events?
So,
advantages,
in general, refs are like to pass the data or call the method from parent to child, while events are to communicate the any information back to parent. Yeah. Any other questions?
But you can use refs even to change the data, right?
Yes.
So it's like,
I mean, child do not have references of parent. Yes. Or there are other patterns as well, but thanks, guys.